Hare Krishna, do you want to see how Prabhupada's sannyasi disciple shows off his marble apartment and says, "This is my house"? If you want to see that, continue watching. Let's go back to the ABC of Krishna consciousness. What is the definition of a sannyasi and a pure devotee who is qualified to lead us back to Godhead? This is someone who dedicates all his money and time for Krishna, not for himself personally. So if a pure devotee has some money, he will open a temple for preaching of Krishna consciousness, or he will spend it in some other way which broadcasts Prabhupada's message. For example, he can buy a van for book distributors. But he will never buy his personal marble apartments. Now we will read from Bhagavad Gita, chapter 12, verse 16 purport. The pure devotee does not endeavor for anything which is against the principles of devotional service. For example, constructing a big building requires great energy, and a devotee does not take to such business if it does not benefit him by advancing his devotional service. He may construct a temple for the Lord, and for that he may take all kinds of anxiety, but he does not construct a big house for his personal relations. Big Buck Govinda Swami purchased not one, not two, but three apartments on the second floor of Talavan building in Rasamrita Kunj. Rasamrita Kunj is located in Mayapur, and we talked about it. It's a luxury apartment complex that we already described in our previous video. So he purchased a half of the whole floor. Estimated cost of that investment is at least $150,000 US dollars. Other half of the second floor is taken by Shivaram Swami. That is another $150,000. But as we said in our last video, if you buy apartment in Rasamrita Kunj, it is expected that you will record a small advertisement video so that other sannyasis can follow in your footsteps and also buy a luxury apartment. So let's look at Big Buck Govinda Swami advertising his luxury apartments.
Hare Krishna, this is Bibi Govinda Swami at Rasamrita Kunj in Mayapur. I've had the fortune of being able to stay here while in Mayapur. And I really have to admit, it's very, very peaceful here. This whole complex is coming up in a very aesthetic way. We're in a green area. I think you can see behind me how beautiful it is. We're about a 30-minute walk from the ISKCON campus, so there's, you know, not a lot of devotees moving around over here. Once again, I'd like to emphasize the peacefulness.
Peacefulness. Yes. Once you buy $150,000 apartment, you can be peaceful, because our inner peace is achieved when we buy expensive luxury apartments, especially sannyasis. I mean, I don't see anybody more peaceful than Big Buck Govinda Swami. Why is he so peaceful? Because he doesn't know that sannyasi is not supposed to buy luxury apartments. He didn't read Bhagavad Gita yet, because he doesn't have time to read Bhagavad Gita, since he must lead Kirtan Melas all the time. And people who are participating in Kirtan Melas, they also don't like Bhagavad Gita. Because reading Bhagavad Gita kind of prevents you from buying luxury apartments. You know, all this renunciation stuff is written there.
30 years ago, Shivaram Swami and I acquired a piece of property that was behind Krishna Balaram Mandir in Vrindavan.
Did you hear this? He said sannyasis obtaining properties. Since when sannyasis are obtaining properties? What is this nonsense? This sentence actually inspired me to look for Bibi Govinda Swami's Vrindavan property. He also has luxury apartment there. And I will show that video in a few minutes.
And at that time, that place was vacant. And we were actually afraid to get a place further away because we were thinking that we may be subject to dacoits and bandits and so forth and so on.
Dacoits? Bandits? What do you mean? I mean, sannyasis are poor. They don't have any material possessions. Why would they be afraid of bandits? Sannyasi must be fearless. That's one of the first qualifications. Strange remark.
Now that whole area of Vrindavan has become grown up. But the beauty of Rasamrita is that it's close to ISKCON, walking distance, but still it's far away on the banks of the Jalangi. It's what you need when you come to India.
No, this is not what you need when you come to India, especially if you are a sannyasi. What you need as a sannyasi is to inspire others by your example of renunciation and knowledge. And renunciation starts by not buying luxury apartments. The last thing you need as a sannyasi is a luxury apartment, because Prabhupada will not be happy with you. Sannyasi with a luxury apartment is a big disgrace to Prabhupada's movement. It portrays Prabhupada as a fake saint who produced fake sannyasis.
Generally, we come to India, and though it's the land of Dharma, we fly into the airports, and then we try to get to our residences as soon as possible. This is a beautiful residence to come to. I've had a very, very wonderful time since I've been here. The staff at Rasamrita, they're all, you know, they go 1,000% out of their way to try to accommodate you.
Of course they do 1,000% to accommodate you. If you paid me $150,000 for an apartment in India, I would accommodate you by jumping around in a bear costume if necessary. I would do everything. Very nice.
The regular shuttle service that goes to the temple. It's just a wonderful place. So I would like to suggest that if any of my friends out there who may see this clip, if you're thinking about perhaps getting a place in the Dham where you could live, you know, think Rasamrita Kunja here in Gordham, Shidam Mayapur. And next time you're in Mayapur, come down and check out this beautiful place. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.
Dear friends of Big Buck Govinda Swami, if you are a sannyasi and you buy a luxury apartment in Rasamrita Kunj, my spies will report in and you and I will make video about you, okay? And if you are on the guru list, I will mark you as red on my purified guru list, which means not advisable to take initiation from. Okay? Good luck with your apartment. You have been warned. Big Buck Govinda Swami mentioned that he has a property in Vrindavan. So now I will show you video of his apartment in Vrindavan, which also costs a lot of money because it is full of marble. Nice marble. Now we will fast forward this video until we can actually see the big buck Govinda Swami's face, so that we are sure that it is him who is recording the video.
This is me watching the rain in Vrindavan, everybody. Hare Krishna. Everybody hold on a second. I'll go inside the house and I'll show you my new deities.
Oh yeah. The tour starts. Look at the marble. Listen carefully. The most important moment will come soon. Big Buck Govinda Swami will say, and I quote, "This is my altar in my house in Vrindavan."
So this is my altar in my house in Vrindavan. And
here you go. We have a confession. Nice. Now, here is the hypocrisy. Here, he shows picture of Srila Prabhupada as if he is follower of Srila Prabhupada. But Prabhupada was crystal clear about the rules in the sannyas ashram. No private apartments. So I'm wondering why Big Buck Govinda Swami is watching this picture every day, and does he really remember what Prabhupada said in Chaitanya Charitamrita lecture in 1968? And I quote, "When this is a hint, then this is a hint by Lord Chaitanya that a sannyasi who has renounced everything, if he lives very gorgeously with good dress, a good house and apartment, no, this is not approved by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Then, what is that? What does it mean? A sannyasi living like a first-class gentleman, smoking, and very nice apartment, and some, I mean to say, lady assistant, secretary, what is this? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu did not approve. He must be, as far as possible, whatever is absolutely necessity, he should accept, not more. Yes, that is renounced order of life. Not that in the name of renounced order of life he should live at the expense of the householders very gorgeously. No, this is not sannyas. It is not accepted by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Sampradaya." This is a quote from lecture on Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhya 20, chapter 20, verse 66 to 96, New York, November 21st, 1966. So, Prabhupada was crystal clear in this lecture that luxury apartments for sannyasis is not accepted by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Sampradaya. Yet, Big Buck Swami buys two luxury apartments and puts Prabhupada's picture there, completely disregarding Prabhupada's instructions. Well, I find that hypocritical. We are approaching the end of this video. Next week, we will make a documentary about luxurious life of Shivaram Swami, the King of Hungary. And for the end, let me add that a sannyasi should not allow groupie girls to sing stupid rap songs for him. If you select cheap guru with a luxury apartment, you will go to cheap loka after this lifetime. Hare Krishna, and all glories to Srila Prabhupada.
Yes. Right now.
He seems like a star, he
looks like a kid. He prays every day and takes protein. Govinda Swami, Govinda Swami, Govinda Swami, Govinda Swami. He makes people chant the name of the Lord, the glory of Krishna all around the world. Govinda Swami, Govinda Swami, Govinda Swami, Govinda Swami. The spiritual master belongs to our death. You make us so happy, belongs you to death. Govinda Swami, Govinda Swami, Govinda Swami, Govinda Swami. Please stay with us longer, the king of... Please stay with us longer, take care of yourself, the king of the kirtans, the happiest man. Govinda Swami, Govinda Swami, Govinda Swami, Govinda Swami. Govinda Swami, Govinda Swami, Govinda Swami, Govinda Swami, Govinda Swami, Govinda Swami, Govinda Swami.
Yeah. Oh. Whoa, that was sick. Thank you. Thank you.